less time to eat before the concert, but that was your choice. But so you'll just have to go and get the early bird specials and then come. But that's appropriate because we're all, you know, older. Early bird stuff. Okay, are you guys ready back there? Okay, so we have a band tonight called Mile 12. They'll tell you why it's called Mile 12. I could tell you, but I'll let them. And I just wanted to say that I wanted to quote, I wanted to get literary and quote T.S. Eliot because this reminded me of the fact that we started with a bluegrass band with A.J. Lee and the Blues Summit. Were any of you at that concert? Some of you were. Okay. Pretty good, eh? Yeah, okay. So that was what we would say starting off with a band. Now to get back to Eliot, this is the way the season works. This is the way the season ends. Not with a whimper, but a bang. Okay, so with that said, and not in the same spirit that Eliot wrote it, this is a revision, I'd like to introduce Mile 12.
Doing out there?
Awesome.
I'm the diva, you know. Thank you all for filling this room with your body heat. It's very enjoyable, very pleasant. thank you, folks. This is absolutely wonderful gig and a wonderful place to be playing music. We know of it. We've seen really cool videos of it, and we've been very excited to play it for a while. It's always a pleasure to play to a sold-out crowd, especially in these weird times. It's a real pleasure to play to a sold-out crowd, so thank you all for coming out tonight. This is really special. It feels like something out of another time, you know? It's really cool. Sometimes, like, I scratch my head and I think, like, you know, I'm from Boston, Massachusetts. How did I like become a bluegrass? Like, what am I doing in a bluegrass band, you know? But it's like this perfect little acoustic quintet, right? It's like it's capable of just being on its own as a quintet. It's something really special. And playing in places like this where it's such a natural sound really brings that out. Those were covers, but we'll do a whole bunch of original music for you, including this next one. It's the story of a soldier returning home from war. It's called Jericho. These days I sleep under an open sky, 'cause I can't seem to sleep in my bed. Back before we split up, my wife told me it's just in your head. Shipped out and served my two tours. I retired last year, tried to come back to life as before. But at night I still fly back to Jericho, where we brought their walls tumbling down. Bury my friends.
At night I can fly.
We play in a very straightforward bluegrass quintet lineup, but we don't really let that limit how we write or arrange our music. We try to just let it come out as it comes out and then figure out how to best express it on these instruments. It's very collaborative. One guy who's very, very helpful to have in the room is the guy playing the bass. He's a bit of a mad genius, often hungry. Very tall. Let's see, nearsighted. No, one guy. No, farsighted.
I can't remember.
He's originally from the Upper West Side of New York City. He's a wonderful guy. That's Nate Savage.
Got some other New Yorkers in the crowd. I'm in Western Massachusetts, right? It's like I can't go. Awesome. Wow. Thanks for coming, everyone. And I write a lot of city songs just because that's where I'm from. It feels the most honest to me. So this next one is set kind of in a city in the distant future. And it's a song of what's to come. And called Red Grapes on the Vine. One, two, three.
The sun will bleed into
fiddle solo for you. She's originally from Copeland, Texas. Now makes her home up in Maine. That's Ella Jordan. Now we're gonna do, we like our apocalyptic songs in this band a little bit. It's kind of the MO these days, 2021. And this next one is actually off our last full-length album that we released back there. It's called City on a Hill. And this is the closest song to a title track on the album. It's called City the Drowned. So Evan will lead us through this one.
Brother Murphy.
Brother Murphy, we're in a church. Lead us through.
This song is post-apocalyptic, which is optimistic in its own way.
inside my windows in the night. It's going down to the dark, behind a single white light. Maybe sleep will come, maybe, maybe you won't. When your body says do, and your mind it says no. Maybe one more dream, but have the dreams go down. You can find a bit of sleep tonight and anywhere in town. Keep the coffee shops clean, keep the paper stores clean, keep the wellness on nights, you can never get beat. Thank you.
Aaron Sitlet says rock and roll for you. I didn't really have anything to say. I just wanted to say hi.
Anyone know who that song is sung by? The character in the song? No, I wrote it from the perspective of Odysseus, and I feel like he was having some trouble like staying faithful on that long trip, you know? And he was woke up on the beach naked and found himself in a kind of awkward situation. So I was just trying to think through like what he might have been thinking. You know, that old dog. The narrator of this next song is no one you will have heard of. He's made up by us, and we've come to know him well, I think, at this point. Yeah. This is the sad song of a man who gave everything for his community and kind of the pointlessness of it all. It's called Johnny Oklahoma.
Johnny Oklahoma walked the tunnel to the daylight. Everybody in the crowd stood up to cheer. His jaw was Rushmore granite. His eyes were northern lakes of ice. The morning breeze was all that he needed. His jumpsuit shone with spangled stars. His gloves of crimson leather clutched a helmet, hanging heavy by his side. He stared toward the cannon, sitting centered in the field of grass, its muzzle pointed straight to his heart. Goodbye, Johnny Oklahoma. You were the bravest of us all. Everyone is honored to have known you. Old boys can die, but legends never fall. Johnny Oklahoma climbed the ladder to the cannon's mouth, just 21, smiling straight at death. When he put his visor down and slipped inside the barrel, you could hear a thousand people hold their breath. From a silent swallowing, the cannon blast exploded like the universe, emerging into life. Johnny Oklahoma disappeared into the clouds and left the stillness and the smoke of drifting wine. Goodbye, Johnny Oklahoma. You were the greatest of us all. Everyone is honored to have known you. Old boys can die, but legends
House. That's Corey Brodsky. Yeah.
I was trying to be a rock star. I was trying to skip songs.
Texas, as everybody knows already, and this is an earnest toad song because that's
church into a honky tonk in like under record time. We got one more thing for you in this set, and we'll be back over by the merchandise area back there. We got T-shirts. We got tumblers, like mugs, you know,
hats,
CDs, hats, you name it. We got everything. We even have a bass instructional book for all you bass players out there. And yeah, I'd just love to meet all y'all and talk to you. And yeah, I'm so happy to be playing live music again. Thanks so much for coming out and supporting it. It really means a lot. So, yeah, thank you so much.
Yeah, as Nate said, we have one more, and this is a tune of mine. This is one I named after a street in Connecticut. It's called Hotterdish. Yeah, I'll probably play for this. That's perfect.
One, two. Thank you.
couple things about the break. This is an unusual break because we don't usually go this far into the fall.
How's it going?
Yeah.
We did your song from the perspective of a famous Greek, Odysseus. Now we'll do a famous Roman. In fact, maybe one of the most famous of all of them, Romulus, the original. This one's called Romulus.
Only friend I know, killed by him.
now a song from the perspective of no one in particular, just a very hungover, very sad man. During the set break say that this was either their first time seeing live bluegrass music or that they didn't really grow up listening to bluegrass music. You know, I didn't either. I don't think most of us... Corey, you grew up listening to bluegrass music. Yeah. Corey's like our bluegrass encyclopedia over here. He knows, man. He's the allmusic.com for bluegrass. But, no, I didn't grow up listening to it, but that type of song, just like the post drunken night chaos song, is one of my favorite types, you know. That one's on that album City on a Hill that we made. We clearly write a lot of our own stuff, as we've been saying tonight, but we love covering other brilliant songwriters and songs. And we recorded an EP, our most recent thing that we recorded was this short EP of cover songs, some of our favorite stuff. And this is just like a masterfully written song called Complicated Man, about just chaos, death, destruction, and enjoying all of it. I'm a complicated man. Best keep your distance. My mind, it's a patchwork of levers and pistons. My thinking works backwards from C down to A. If there's a dollar to turn, you'll find me a way.
my tower, from which I look down upon the foes and the powerless, and I hear their rhythm in the shuffle of feet. I hum my melody,
folks. The banjo is a fiddly instrument. Any banjo players out there in the house? Y'all know what I'm talking about. If you, you know, it takes, especially when the weather keeps changing. You know, it's like warm, cold, so. I wish I had a banjo joke to tell. You ever get banjo jokes?
No.
You don't like banjo jokes.
No.
You feel like they.
Tell the one over here during the set break.
Oh yeah, this one has nothing to do with the banjo, but this is a pretty good joke here during the set break. What do Winnie the Pooh and Alexander the Great have in common? Same middle name. Think outside the box. That's a good joke. I love that. Who said it? Credit. Credit where credit's due. All right. Well, we're in a fun mood now. I said a joke. Let's have some fun with some music, right? That's what we're all here for. No, this is a Vernon song. Another city bluegrass song. I didn't write it, but I love it. I sing it. It's called Hello City Limits.
Hello City Limits, I see a sign left on the wall.
worries way behind. Let all the troubles and heartaches that you fell asleep in and so start now brand new. I left all the troubles and heartaches that you fell asleep in and so start now brand new.
One called Evening Prayer that I recorded on a solo EP a couple of years ago. I was raised in a very traditional Irish Catholic family in the suburbs of Boston, and some of my songwriting reflects that, including the self-pity of blue-collar fathers. That's something that I am quite well acquainted with. Speaking of blue, this next song is called Blue Darling, and it's going to be sung by our wonderful fiddle player, Ella Jordan.
Yeah. About this next song. It was written this year by Evan here on guitar, but we haven't quite gotten to the season it takes place in, and we're getting really close now. This song is set in the mountains of New England in the bleak winter time. We all know about that. It's coming up here. It's about as close as we've gotten, and that's all I want to say about it, but picture it, you know, 40 or 50 degrees colder than it is now in this exact location. We finally got it. Light of Angels.
Thank you.
We gotta film the music video for that one out here. You know? Our hands are gonna freeze off, but you know, it'll be dark, it'll be beautiful. We are planning on getting into the studio to record our next full-length album. Hopefully early next year. We'll have it out sometime in the middle of the year. So please stay in touch with us. If you're not already, you can follow us on Instagram, Facebook. Our website's mile12bluegrass.com. We also have a mailing list as well if you want to drop your email to one of us after the show. But we're going to go all the way back to summer now, pull it back from winter, and do one that we've been playing, a festival favorite of ours. Got it from the band Los Lobos. Any Los Lobos fans in the crowd? Yeah, all right, cool. I heard this one on one of their albums and was just like, oh man, this would kill the bluegrass band. It's called Whiskey Trail. And now you can pretend you're at a festival in summer instead. You can go back in time instead of fuck. All right.
Thank you.
Yeah. Hello, everybody. We've come to our very last song, which is very sad, I believe. Yeah. And it's been an absolute pleasure playing for you all. Thank you. Can we give a big round of applause for Paul for organizing this whole thing? To be able to stream this thing on the internet. And big thanks to Andrew for making us sound good. We're gonna wrap up here with a medley of tunes. I think Evan actually wrote some new words for this one, so those of you out there who are like taking notes, you know, don't listen too closely. it's a medley with Rocky Island and fiddle tune called Hellsburg Loose in Georgia, which has another couple of names as well. A lot of people call it different things in different parts of the country. Come say hi to us. I would love to, we met most of you, but would love to say hi before you leave, and thank you for coming to see live music. This is amazing, and have a good night.
didn't ask for me, but I'm here anyway. So I wanted to reaffirm the thanks for Andrew on the sound system, and also Kevin Murphy back there for Frontier Cable Access TV making this music go beyond the chapel here, go beyond even West Whately. And thank you guys for that. And of course, thank you guys for making this the great show it is. So, thank you.
Thank you very much. You've all been really wonderful to play music for. Just a great, friendly audience, and this is a wonderful thing you have going here. It's important to, you know, come out and come to these concerts, because this is, as soon as we walked in the room here, we were looking around, getting ready for sound check, and BB just looked around and went, I love shows like this, you know? And we do, you know? These are just like friendly, great shows like this. We love doing this kind of thing, so thank you. Well, I sang an original song about killing your brother. I sang an original song about avenging the death of your brother. And now here's one that's actually autobiographical about loving your brother. It's called Close Enough to Hear. Just the thought of you this morning was enough to make me smile. I didn't know how much I missed you. I haven't seen you for a while. You were standing in the backyard on a perfect summer day. Your son was pulling on your blue jeans, asking you to come and play. And I thought to say I love you, though I knew you couldn't hear. May the sun shine bright above you, may you always have cold beer. Today I am far from you. Someday soon when we are near, I will think to say I love you. You are close enough to hear. The wind is blowing gently, and I stood sentry at the fire. Evening sun was sinking lower, flames are reaching higher. Felt the laughter rumbling through me as the moon began to shine. Felt the whiskey go right to me. Thank you.
good things really are. Hope is so close you could touch it. Suddenly it comes too far.